into the winter of '08, when finally everything, you know, started caving in, so to speak. The date, '08, the first date of the water damage, is in the center of a lot of the water.
Is this on the floor?
Yeah, those were rugs over there at the time, because I had rugs over a linoleum floor, which used to be here. An old floor that was here in 1991 when I moved in here. The current landlord wasn't the owner of the building at that time. He purchased it in September of 1997. I used to have a conveyor dryer to dry my t-shirts, which was at least 11 feet long.
You want to put this one in?
No, I'll be dressed by the train. Looks nice. I guess it's front.
Yeah, let me just put it through.
Now, this was the window. This is actually the window where there were racks over here with shirts hanging up.
Okay.
So there was a printing machine, which was over here about 8 feet long, 10 feet when extended. That would mean 10 feet from approximately here, back here, to the printer. The dryer started about right over here.
Okay.
Then the store and extended another 12 feet or so to the back, because here's the beginning. So just plug here?
Sure.
This was a direct electrical cord that we plugged, we had to have installed when I moved here. With the prior landlord, in 1981, to extend a dryer cord wired down directly into the fuse box of the basement.
Are these pictures from the front of the store?
This is the back.
Okay.
This is the main spot. Okay. And the back end of the dryer, right below the shirt dryer, where the damages occurred. This over here was a cover to like a Dropbox. We used to print shirts. We'd let the shirts fall down into the box, remove the cover. When we weren't using it, I'd just keep this cover on.
These are all the back, right? These are all the back.
This is all, yeah, all the water damage was basically from this wall right here. What you see over here was an old stack.
Any issues or concerns with the back of the store behind
yes.
the door?
Okay. When we got around, they were...
Well, we haven't gotten there yet.
Correct.
For this.
They now put a rear door on the side over there. There was never a door there. It used to be just a solid foundation, no rear door exit.
Give me one sec.
Sure.
Hey, Joanne. I'm on an inspection, please quick. Please quick, I'm gonna need it. Can I call you back like in a half hour? That makes sense, yeah. Sounds good. Okay, thanks.
Was what was the back wall before a flight of stairs, like three steps that went down into the back area of the store.
Okay. So these are all now back of the store.
Right.
Not here, back.
This right over here is exactly where the shirt dryer began.
Okay.
So the plug was here, it stuck out maybe right to where the sink was put in, which was over there before.
Okay.
And extended back to that point. This right over here is where
okay, I have an idea. That's good, thank you. I'm going to just walk around the street just following the address. Thank you. right in this room?
This is completely new. This is exactly the back part of the front of these. This is the staircase, this is going up to the apartment above. This is the wall, and then this was a warped entrance. This is where there's like a path we used to walk from in front of the desk, right over here, right in between this wall over here.
Is this what you're referring to me as the storage room?
This is the back, no, this is the back part of the front area to store, that wall back there.
Okay.
This is all new over here, here's the old light that was up.
Uh-huh.
This is the staircase top over here going up to the stairs. Here's the old ceiling that was up over here. Here you can see prior damage over here.
I'm not allowed to do an invasive inspection, but I'm allowed to collect samples.
Yes.
So for you, taking samples would include sampling the ceiling. Not an issue for you?
As long as it's like, I'm assuming using swabs.
No, I'm not. I'm going to take a bulk sample of it.
No. We were told it was swabs.
Not if you read my proposal.